Gentili signore, signori, autorità
Ladies
presenti,
and gentlemen, authorities, let me extend my warmest thanks to all of you for being here and for attending this event, which for the third year is a forum for us to discuss topics which we consider to be extremely important for our future and for planning the time ahead of us and the generations who will come after us. We live in a time which is characterized by some global paradoxes. Three in particular have long raised our attention and they strengthen our firm belief that we wanted to study, to create a study center with innovative breakthrough features. The first paradox is that globally, at the same time, we have over 1 billion people who suffer from hunger, and we have just as many people, just another billion people, who suffer the consequences of hypernutrition or malnutrition under the shape of serious metabolic diseases, including diabetes. However, even today, the global food system is in a situation to guarantee suitable nutrition for all the living beings on the planet. The reasons for this situation are not easy to identify and remove. However, this should not discourage those who care for the destiny of millions of men and women who suffer from the tragedy and of hunger and misery. On the other hand, this should prompt us to identify new and effective solutions. The second paradox is relevant to the existence on the planet of about 3 billion heads of cattle. One-third of the whole global food production is earmarked for feeding cattle, whilst 1 billion people has limited and insufficient access to drinking water, and about 4,000 children lose their lives every day for that reason. The production of 1 kilogram of meat, considering the whole cattle life cycle, requires as much as 15,000 liters of water. Once again, this is a model that that needs rethinking and reviewing. The third paradox is another type of unsuitable use of Earth's resources, the competition between biofuels and food. A growing amount, a growing acreage of agricultural land is now earmarked for producing biofuels, which means we want to provide drinking material to our cars and not food for human beings in need. The growing awareness about these imbalances has prompted us to think about the most effective ways to communicate and to involve whoever is interested in going deeper into these topics in a way that's got to be independent, serious, and scientifically accurate. This need to inform, involve, communicate, and discuss in order to propose solutions was the basis for the creation of the Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition in 2009. We are a center of analysis and proposals. We have a multidisciplinary approach with the objective of going deeper into the far-reaching issues connected to nutrition and food on a global scale. We want to listen to the emerging needs of our societies by means of gathering global and world-level competences and experiences, and by fostering a continuous open dialogue. In its first 3 years of business, the Center has collected and disseminated numerous scientific publications under the guidelines of institutional deadlines and the priorities in international political agendas. I think we were able to strengthen our role as a collector and connector between science and research on one side and political decision-making and government actions on the other side. Amongst the numerous events that were open to the civil society organized by the Barilla Food for Center for Nutrition, the most important event is the reason why we're all here today, the International Forum for Food and Nutrition, an important international event gathering top experts in this sector that has now reached its third year. In these 2 days, we'll discuss topics, all topics related to food and nutrition in a serious and very open and free way. Hopefully, we'll not just share what we already know, but we'll also contribute to generating new knowledge by means of continuous open dialogue and comparison and discussion of very different positions as well. To close, I wish to thank the members of the advisory board who have been working in this adventure with us. Without them, whatever we'll see and listen to in the next few days would not be possible. And if you allow me, I warmly want to wish my all of my best to Mr. Mario Monti, who's left the center to take up an even greater challenge. Thank you very much. Enjoy the meeting.